Good morning, everybody. Thanks for coming to the second PROFCon, PROFCon 22. It was by invitation. I wanted a select audience to understand about PROF, to get the presentations and reconnect with the police, the fire people, Ukraine. A lot of people think of PROF and they think of me and they think that PROF isn't for me. PROF is ours now. We're strategic partners. We're in an industry that needs its attention. We're in an industry where a lot of the models are broken. And the reason for creating PROF was to create a platform into the government and for government to have a platform into us. So thanks for coming today. We'll start off with video of how PROF was launched and where we are today and our strategic partnerships.
Ill-conceived. I think the public awareness and the time and money that's gone into making the public aware, our people's safety is of paramount importance, but also the safety of the public that we go out and move every single day, thousands of times a day, every single day. We are an emergency service. We're not given the proper concessions to be an effective emergency service. This inquiry and some of the implications that come from it could be vital in us being able to do that job. So I'd like you just to take that on board, please, because we need the recognition, we need the support.
I'm enormously proud that you've come together to actually have an organisation that speaks with one voice. I know how difficult that is. I know, particularly in this place, I know how difficult it will be sometimes that you will fall out with each other. But actually, stick together, because if you stick together, we stand a chance of changing what's going on out there and having a safe industry, which is what we really need. We can't stop people breaking down. We can't stop accidents and collisions taking place, but we can certainly make your operatives and the public much safer.
I'm one of the initial founders of Fair Fuel UK, and that's the most successful lobbying group in British modern political history. And it's simply done by really public protest and really being right, and as Mike says, evidence-based support. And you just push, push, push. And the public will be completely and utterly behind you because the nation's roads are in the worst state they've ever been. And the information we get from Highways Agency, Highways England, DFT, sometimes isn't right. And I don't say that with any irony, and the debate gets skewed, and the press get pressurized by the environmentalists, and all of a sudden, we're losing focus on our economic lifeline, which is our roads. 95% of everything we buy in the shop travels by road. We can't ignore it, and we have a third world road economy for a first world economy. So what you're doing is hugely significant. Take heart that it can be done, and with support from people like Mike, the politicians here and in Whitehall will listen very carefully to what you say. So you have my complete unstinting support. Well done.
This initiative, this launch of the Professional Recovery Operators Federation is incredibly important for lobbying parliamentarians, and I'm very keen to listen carefully to what you say as an organisation.
When I was a kid, speaking of dreams, I used to like Thunderbirds. It's one of my favourite programmes. International Rescue. They were a secret society. No one knew where they came from. No one knew where they went. No one knew who built their amazing machines. They risked their lives, and every week they risked their lives and they saved the people they went out to. Little did I know when I joined the recovery industry, that's exactly what I've joined. Because that's what we do. Well, the best kept secret, essentially, with the fourth emergency service, yet nobody knows what we do, nobody knows where we come from, no one knows how we fund ourselves, and no one knows what they'd do if we weren't around. But I'm sure if you gave it some thought, you could think, without the recovery industry, risking their lives 24/7, the roads, the country would come to a standstill. But we don't really want to go there. People need to understand that the recovery industry is the fourth emergency service. But people need to understand it's not vehicles moving other vehicles. It's people moving people. And anything that we can do to keep those people safe, there needs to be a very good reason why we can't do that.
I'm sorry that ministerial business prevents me from being with you today in Telford at your annual gathering. To the stranded motorists you rescue, you are in a very real sense the fourth emergency service. The recently formed Professional Recovery Operators Federation is playing a vital role in informing the work of the APPG.
Some sort of insight into where PROF started, what it intends to do, the signing of the strategic partnership agreements, I believe now gives us a partnership together in an industry with the other emergency services, with the IBR, a proper recovery industry platform, like I said, that government will listen to, but we've got to have something to say. This platform isn't for me. And what we do with this platform is up to you people. It's what you want out of this industry. This industry is broken at the moment, and we all understand that it is. But there's certain things that if we work together, we can improve. There's certain parts of the government that we need to have more communication. You saw all those MPs up there. Well, to be honest, Prof's got more MP support than Grant Chats has got when we go for the leader of the Tory party. So we have got the support. What we do with that and what we want to do with that is important. One of the first places that I wanted to start with was the elephant that had been in the room with regards to police contracts. And when I first got in contact with the National Police Chiefs Council, I was unbelievably surprised in how receptive, how communicative, how proactive they've been in trying to work with the recovery industry. Contrary to popular belief, the trade association that's apparently negotiating with them won't and aren't and will not. And the movement that we've had we're going to have in stat fees and with dealing with the police, it's been phenomenal. And it's a great big thanks to them for being here today, to reconnecting with the recovery industry. And that's what PROF is going to be about, reconnecting with the people that matter, that will help us to not just stat fees, not just everything that is breakdown and recovery. Everything we can do to improve it, the standard, the safety, everything. And if we have that line, we can go to government, we can go to maybe even Sadiq Khan if he's awake, but anybody, and people will listen to us. Because what we want is to make things better, not worse. And it's not just about money, it's about improving the industry that we all work in together. So thanks for coming. I hope you find The presentation is informative. And are you going to introduce her? Thanks for coming.